Hello students, how are you? Okay, in the last class I shared one link of one video from the YouTube with you about sound chapter. So we will start with the sound chapter. So I hope you would you must have got some basic knowledge about the sound, like what is sound or how it is produced. Okay, so we will start with the sound chapter today. Just pay attention, and as I told you, like whatever I will discuss with you in the class, that will only come in your exams. So no need to study those things which is not explained to you. Okay, now what is sound? I told you before also, like I told you in case of light also, that light is a form of energy. Anything which does work is called as energy. So sound is also a sound. Is, you can see here, please open page number 234. Please underline that sound is a form of energy. Okay, sound is a form of energy. Sound is that form of energy which makes us hear. And now in our daily life we hear different types of sounds, like what different types of sounds you can hear, like telephone bell, radio sound, television sound, mixer, grinder, washing machine, sound of bus, car, truck, and sound of aeroplane. So you hear lot of different types of sounds. Okay, and you also know that like the sound, each sound, the sounds, they are different from each other. Like the sound of a car will be different from sound of a washing machine. Okay, so each sound is, please underline, each sound is special to the object which produces it. Now sound of a washing machine will be different. Okay, it will not be similar to that of a sound of a bell or sound of a clock. Okay, so each sound is special to the object which produces it. Understood? Now here, please see here, we can also, by hearing the sound of a particular thing or a particular object or a particular person, we can also recognize that person without looking the face of that person or that object. Okay, so each sound has a particular speciality or a quality. Okay, so you please underline, we can even recognize a person from the sound of his voice even without seeing his face. For example, we can usually tell from the voice which singer is singing a particular song on a radio even though we do not see the face of a singer. Thus every sound has a unique quality. Okay, every sound has a unique quality. My sound is different from your sound. Okay, or your sound is different from your friend's sound. So that is why we are able to recognize the sound of different persons just by hearing the sound and without seeing the face of a person. Now another thing is how the sounds are produced. How sound is produced? It is very simple if you understand it, and if you don't understand it, then it is very very difficult. Sound is produced by a vibrating body. First of all, you have to understand the meaning of vibrating, vibrations. What do you understand by vibrations? Please underline, when an object moves backward and forward, okay, and to and fro rapidly, we say that the object vibrates. When the object moves backward and forward, suppose this is a pen. So if this pen is moving backward, forward, okay, this is a vibration. Okay, suppose this is point A, this is point A. Now, or let us say this is any object A. So if this object moves this side, this side, this side, this side, or up and down, okay, then it is called as vibration. Across a mean position, suppose this is a object, okay, now this object, this is the mean position of the object. Here the object is stationary, so I will say that this is the mean position. Let us say this is O. Now if you will push or hit the object, it will start moving. How it will move? It will move like this. It will move like this. See here, it will come to position A, then from position A it will go back to mean position, then it will go to position B. then again it will come, again it will come to mean position, then it will go to A. So this process will continue and this is called as vibration, means move across a mean position. So this is the mean position and this is called as vibration. You can also see in this way also, suppose if this is O, this is the mean position of this object, let me say this is the object, okay. Now if you will hit this object will move here, let me say this is A, from here it will come back to O, it will move here, so this is B, then again A, again B, again A, again B. Actually the distance is same here, I have made this a little bit more, but the distance later on you will study that, let me say till here it will reach. Okay, so to and fro motion across a mean position like this, like you can see the movement of my pen, or like this. So this is called as vibrations. So sound is produced by a vibrating bodies. Okay, I hope you all have understood what is vibration. Please underline here, sound is produced by vibrating bodies. Now please see here. Now students, in some cases the vibrations are so much, like the vibration of a sound producing object are so large that you can easily see it. But in some cases it is very very small, you cannot see it and you can feel it weakly, okay. So, but it doesn't mean that the vibration, the body is not vibrating. For example, if you will take, you take glass, steel glass you take, okay, and hit that glass. Okay, and what you will hear the sound of a glass, but you will not be able to see the vibrations. Okay, but it doesn't mean that it's not vibrating. It is vibrating, because if you hit the glass and you just touch it lightly, lightly, very lightly, you can feel the vibrations. Okay, so sound is produced by a vibrating object. Vibrations can be large, vibrations can be very very weak, okay, very very small. Now you can see this, it's a common observation. Let us ring a bicycle bell. When you ring a bicycle bell and when you touch, you feel that it moves and sound is produced. Okay, so the bell is vibrating. Okay, and if you will hold it tightly and you will stop the bell movement, what will happen? You will stop hearing the sound of the cycle bell, because now the cycle bell stops vibrating. Okay, this is one example. So underline, sound is produced by vibrating bicycle bell. Second example is this. What is this? Yes, iron or brass plate. It's very easy. If you take a iron or brass plate, or you take the case of the bell or the temple bell, you forget for some time. If you take a plate, iron plate, or even a steel plate which you use at home to eat the food or to keep the food, so if you will hit it, it will produce sound, a tingling sound is produced. So why, how it is produced? Because the plate, it vibrates, though you cannot see it, but if you will touch it, you can feel it. Okay, now here you take, this is very very easy, you see this is, these are the two nails, you take a rubber band, stretch it and tie it in these two nails. Okay, now you see here, now this is the mean position, O. This is the fixed mean position, is the fixed position. So this is the mean position. Now you gently pluck it. Okay, what will happen if you will pluck it? You will hear sound, definitely you will hear sound, but now actually what is happening, the rubber band has started vibrating. This rubber band, when you pluck it, this will move up, then it will come back, then it will come down. So it is vibrating across the mean position. This is the mean position, you can see here. Okay, now if I draw a line here, okay, so that is zero, that is the mean position. Now when you will pluck, it will go on top, which is A, then it will pass through the mean position O and it will go to B. Like this it will vibrate across. So, and it will start moving, it will vibrate and you can hear the sound. But when you will hold it tightly, okay, the vibrations will stop and you will not be able to hear the sound. So sound is produced by the vibrating body. Here this is a stretched rubber band which produces sound. Even in sitar, you know, in guitar, the strings are there. So when you plug those strings, even you can see the strings there, you can see the strings vibrating, and when the strings vibrate, the sound is produced. Okay, sitar, I have already explained you, please underline. Sound is produced when the sitar string vibrates. The sound of a veena is also produced by the vibration of a stretched strings. When we talk, now I am talking to you, I am explaining, you can hear, I am saying some words, but how the sound is produced by me? Because you know that in the throat there are vocal cords, okay? Vocal cord, there is a sound box called as larynx. Suppose this is trachea, okay? In detail we will study when I will explain you human ear, okay? Now suppose this is a trachea. On the top of the trachea there is a voice box which is called as larynx, okay? Now this larynx has vocal cords. This larynx has two vocal cords. Now if you want, you can just touch the throat lightly, or you speak to someone, or you sing a song, you can hear something vibrating, something moving. Now what happens when you talk or when you sing a song? Okay, this is trachea and here lungs are. Okay, lungs are. Okay, lungs are here. This trachea divides into bronchi which enters into a lung. And here there is a voice box, this is larynx which has a vocal cord. So when you speak or when you sing, the air from the lung passes out, it passes through these vocal cords, and this vocal cords, due to the force or the pressure of the air, it starts vibrating, and that is why the sound is produced. I know there are many questions in your mind, like how we are able to produce different types of words and all those things, that you will study later on. Okay, whatever I have told you before also, first of all, whatever is there in the syllabus, understand the basic things, then in detail you will study in higher classes. Many things you will study in your higher classes. Everything you will not study in class 8. Here you have to have a basic knowledge. You will study the basic things, and if you are thorough with the basic things, then higher level of things you will study in higher classes, because sound, it is produced in a wave form. All these things you will study in higher classes. Okay, so that all is given here in point 4. Now if you blow air, if you blow across the mouth of an empty test tube, if you blow, so a sound is produced, or if you will in a whistle, how the sound is produced, because there the air column, air is present, and the air, it starts vibrating, and you can see the, and you can hear the sound. Okay, when the air column enclosed in, even in the test tube, if you take an empty test tube, or if you take an empty glass also, and if you blow air, you can hear the sound, because what is present in it, air is present. Suppose if this is an empty test tube, it appears to be empty, but what is present inside? Air is present. So when you blow air is already present. When you blow more air, what happens? This air along with the air which you blow, that starts vibrating and sound is produced. Okay, so sound is produced by the air column. Now here you see, this is, what is this? This is drum. So when you will hit this drum, you can hear the sound. You will not see the membrane of the drum moving or vibrating, but actually the it vibrates, okay, and that is why the sound is produced. Now how you can find out that it vibrates? What you do, you keep some pebbles over it or some beads over the membrane, over the drum, and then you hit the drum, you will see that the pebbles or the beads starts moving, which shows that the membrane of the drum, it is vibrating or it vibrates. Okay, so please underline, sound can be produced by the following methods: by vibrating strings, vibrating air column, by vibrating membrane, by vibrating plates. Now another thing is the propagation of sound, how the sound, it travels. Like I am speaking, if I am taking an online class or in a sorry offline class, if I stand at one place and if I teach it, everyone can hear, or you can hear what other people speak. But what does it mean? It means that sound, it travels, or you can say propagation of sound. So how the sound, it travels from one place to another place, that we will discuss in next class. And please revise whatever we have discussed today. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.